3, 2, 1.
This lab is usually used for airliner crash tests. But on this day, researchers at Wichita State University are studying what happens when a drone falls from the sky onto someone below.
Happens if we really do have a drone running into an airliner, colliding with people on the ground. We also have to answer that worst case scenario for the FAA.
The federal government is about to unveil new rules that will open America's airspace to widespread commercial drone use. In a matter of months, it's projected thousands could take flight. Companies like Amazon have already launched ambitious marketing campaigns for how they'll use drones to deliver packages directly to your front door.
It's a really massive moment in aviation history.
Retired Air Force General James Poss leads a team of universities and private companies studying the dangers of drones to people and planes for the FAA.
This is a full-scale drone that's hitting the vertical stabilizer on a wide-body transport.
This lab uses 3D scans to simulate mid-air collisions between drones and planes. Manufacturers already test the dangers of birds to airplanes. There are about 14,000 bird strikes a year.
Going boom.
A flock of geese famously took down a U.S. Airways flight dubbed the Miracle on the Hudson in 2009. The fear is drones could do much more damage.
Which is more dangerous, the drone or the bird?
Drones are made of very, very hard components, engines, cameras, batteries, that could do significant damage to the aircraft. What our research is trying to prove or disprove is just how much damage they would do.
To get that proof, researchers try to duplicate a drone hitting a plane at full speed.
This is a battery of a drone, and researchers shoot components like this through this cannon at a rate of 200 miles per hour. It's meant to mimic what could happen if a drone and a plane collided midair.
3, 2, 1.
So far, tests like this have shown a drone can do significant damage, but conclusive data is still months away.
And we need to figure out what's safe to do with these drones and what's the probability of these accidents happening.